go rounds, and it should be exciting the whole way.
Did Bones Adams get jobbed over the weekend? I know you spoke to him. We want your scorecard on that as well. Bob Papa has the night off, so we send it out to Sean Wheelock and Teddy Atlas.
Thanks, Brian and Max. Welcome live to Foxwoods Resort Casino in Ledger, Connecticut for Friday Night Fights presented by Miller High Life. We begin tonight with a 10-round bout in the lightweight division. Daniel Alicea versus Julian Wheeler. Julian Wheeler, a 1992 U.S. Olympian, 30 years old, 5'9", comes into this bout at 137 pounds from Virginia Beach, Virginia. His record, 26-1, only 8 KOs in his last 5 fights. A record of 3 victories and 2 losses. His opponent's an impressive record, though, of 89-28-3, 67 KOs, 74% winning percentage. Daniel Alicea, originally from Puerto Rico, now living and fighting out of Newark, New Jersey, 28 years old, 5'8", weighs in tonight at 136¼ pounds, a record of 24-4-1 with 19 KOs. In his last 5 fights, a record of 3-2 with 3 KOs. His opponent, 73-38-4 with 50 KOs, 64% on the winning percentage. Well, just 97 days since Julian Wheeler last fight, and that proved to be a turning point for his career. In Julian Wheeler's last bout on May 4th in nearby Uncasville, Connecticut, Wheeler looking very impressive. He scored an 8-round unanimous decision over the very tough Israel Pito Cardona. That snapped a personal 2-match losing streak for Julian Wheeler. So coming into tonight, Wheeler looks for another big victory. He sets his strategy.
Well, I want to come out tonight and box. Look good also while I'm doing it. And from the fight last few months ago, so I want to look impressive in every fight. So tonight, I'm gonna go out there and throw more punches, try not to get hit that much, and from here on out, just keep going with that, keep winning, looking impressive.
Michael Ortega is the referee. Let's check out the rules tonight. We do use the unified rules of the Association of Boxing Commissioners here in Connecticut. No 3 knockdown rule, no standing 8, only the referee may stop the fight. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round. Accidental foul, you go to the scorecards after 4 rounds are complete. So Julian Wheeler at age 30 may be getting a second life on that big victory, winning over Pito Cardona. Had he lost that, it would have been 3 straight defeats, maybe the end of his career. Now looking to turn things around tonight against Daniel Alicea.
Alicea has to difficult job of fighting a tough fight after having been knocked out in his last bout 8 months ago. That is always very difficult, very important for a fighter like Alicea, who's coming back off a knockout loss, to get a couple rounds of confidence in, get his legs under him, let him know psychologically he's okay. In other words, the early going for a guy coming off a knockout loss, he's always the toughest.
Alicea has knocked out 19 of his opponents, but he's also been knocked out 3 times. And since that last fight, a knockout loss, 236 days of inactivity for Alicea. I think that would just fester and fester on you psychologically, Teddy, knowing you lost, you were knocked out, and you haven't fought since.
The only good news there in those statistics that you can build on is 2 of the 4 losses Alicea has suffered have been to world champions. And 2 of those knockout losses, including his last one, have been to great punches. Prince Hamed and Asselino Freitas, who knocked him out in his last fight. Terrific bangers. And another piece of good news for Alicea, Wheeler is not a banger.
That loss against Hamed, Alicea came in 15-0, 13 KOs in the Prince of Newcastle, England, taking him out in 2 rounds. Perhaps not ready for that challenge at that stage of his career.
Alicea is a good offensive puncher, good offensive fighter. He is the puncher of these 2 fighters.
Wheeler has to feel, Teddy, that maybe he saved his career. You would think at age 30, 3 straight losses, and it was conceivable he could have lost to Pito Cardona, especially in Connecticut, Pito's home state. Well, what does that do for your career? Wheeler landing a nice right hand there.
The right hand will be there for Will, I believe. Because Alicea has a habit of laying, finishing his head on the right side, on his right side. That's in a path where he could get hit by a right hand with an orthodox fighter like Will. And that's exactly what he got caught with, but his leg slipped from underneath him and the referee is going to rule it not a knockdown.
Good ruling by the referee, Michael Ortega, very quick, saying it was a slip. Closing seconds, round number one, scheduled for 10 here in Foxwoods in the lightweight division.
Time.
Well, coming up tonight in our main event on Friday Night Fights, NABF 140-pound champion Ray Oliveira in the first defense of his title against knockout artist Ben Tacky of Ghana in a 12-round bout. Oliveira versus Tacky, still to come for the NABF super lightweight title here on Friday Night Fights. Glad you're with us, everyone. With Teddy Atlas, I'm Sean Wheelock, in for Bob Papa. Teddy, always a pleasure to be with you. And in our main event, interesting fight, two very contrasting styles.
Yeah, you do have two different styles. There's no doubt about it. And I think two good styles for the people watching. Offensive styles. On one hand, you have a guy who just kind of grinds it out, kind of like football teams, like a running attack where they just bang it out all the time. Oliveira's a guy who just grinds it out. He's not a big banger, but boy, does he throw a lot of punches. On the other side of the ledger, hey, the St. Louis Rams, a guy who can strike from any end of the field, who can all of a sudden put points right up on that board. No doubt about it, Ben Tacky has that power in his gloves to change the fight around.
Oliveira, such a fun fighter. He throws so many punches. That's still to come. 12 rounds for the NABF title in our main event. This round number two, scheduled for 10, lightweight division. 1992 U.S. Olympian Julian Wheeler facing Daniel Alicea. See the punches in round number one. Wheeler tripling on the percentage. Alicea was put down to the canvas, but the referee, Michael Ortega, correctly ruling it a slip. Wheeler growing in confidence, I think, here in round number two, Teddy. Nice right hand on the feint with the left.
Look for that right hand all night from Wheeler, unless Alicea, at least in my opinion, makes an adjustment, does not lay his head on the right side. Sean, when you lay your head on the right side, you are in a path where the orthodox fighter can score that right hand. You need to finish with your head moving on the left, where you're outside the right hand. If you're going to finish on the right side, you need to be close all the way out, not right in front of your man. Again, there's that right hand from Wheeler. He sees it.
Wheeler's camp has to know this will most likely go the distance, although we told you Alicea has been stopped three times. Wheeler, and this is 28th fight, has recorded just 8 KOs. 4 of those 8 came in his first 5 fights when he was really getting soft competition coming out of the Olympics. Teddy, he's just simply not a knockout fighter.
The power in this fight, where there is power, belongs, as I said earlier, to Alicea. Will is a guy with plenty of heart, plenty of ring savvy, but not big pop.
Wheeler was caught with that right hand by Alicea. Alicea throws the same punch and misses. Now to the body. Teddy, is it frustrating for a fighter like Wheeler knowing that he really doesn't have the knockout power, and against pretty good competition such as Daniel Alicea, he's gonna have to put in the work and it's almost certainly going to go to the judges' scorecards?
You have to have a good defense and you have to be a real good boxer, and it's really, really extra pressure on you to be a real busy fighter. Sometimes to even take more chances by being offensively minded when you don't have that big bang in your glove.
Wheeler stopped Julio Jimenez in the 7th round, September 98. That was his last knockout victory.
Right now, Wheeler has made a nice little adjustment this round.
Step back clean.
Trying to control range nicely, distance nicely. Trying to pick up Alicea coming forward.
Enfrente. Time.
This man may not bowl many strikes, but don't you think he's not still at the top of his game? His scores are not reflected in his average. His scores cannot be measured with hash marks and excess. Even between frames, he keeps his roller going. Here's to you, you old polecat. You keep on living the high life.
ESPN2 Friday Night Fights is presented by Miller High Life and in part by Cascade Complete. Skip the sink. Friday Night Fights presented by Miller High Life. With Teddy Atlas, I'm Sean Wheelock, in for Bob Papa. We've got a good card for you tonight. This is our opening bout, Julian Wheeler versus Daniel Alicea. Round number 3, scheduled for 10 in the lightweight division.
This is round 3.
You see Alicea. Wheeler may be a little too slick for him in the opening 2 rounds.
Bueno.
No. Backhand, okay?
Warning by the referee, Michael Ortega, to Alicea for throwing the backhand. Wheeler right back to the body. Punches in round number 2. Actually thrown more by Alicea, but Wheeler more effective. That's really a poor percentage, just 10% landed. Guys weighing in the 130s, Teddy, you really expect more.
It's the back clean.
That's why people love, usually, to watch the smaller weight classes. They see action. The bigger, heavier weight classes. More selective action.
Step back. No.
Knowing this Wheeler is, lacks knockout power, knowing there's a good chance this will go the distance, Alicea obviously has to do more than land 10% of his punches.
Alicea should think about going to the body a little bit. Seeing that Wheeler has shown defensive capabilities. There's a nice body shot.
With the left hand. Teddy, your scorecard after 2. Level is 19 apiece. You gave Alicea round number 1.
Yes, I did. I thought he caught Wheeler by surprise a little bit, coming out aggressive. Eating up the first part of the round before Wheeler shifted gears a little bit and maybe stole the last part of the round. Close. Difficult round to score.
Almost like you're training Julian Wheeler, because since you made the comment, he's been throwing to the body of Daniel Alicea.
That's where he should be going. You missed the head. Go to the body. You can rely on a body being in front of you.
Teddy, if I know I'm not a knockout fighter at this weight class, why not go to the body constantly and wear your man down? You've proven now in your 28th fight, you really aren't going to get guys out with throwing upstairs.
That's a good point.
Shoulder.
Don't possess that nitro in your hands. One place you can always hurt a guy, bother a guy, even if you're not a banger, is if you catch him clean in the right spot in the body.
Alicea starting to get a little wide, a little wild with his punches, especially the right hand. Just off the mark there.
Uppercut!
Uppercut!
Bueno!
Wheeler has a little advantage physically in the length of his arms. That's why I think he's a little bit better served on the outside.
No loitering means get out of here. Rookies.
Brought to you locally by Penco Tech, turning dreams into reality.
If IKEA can update this classic, imagine the possibilities for your home.
4th round scheduled for 10 lightweights. Julian Wheeler versus Daniel Alicea.
Hey,
Wheeler starting to throw to the body more in round three. We'll see if he continues on in round number four. Punches through three rounds of this fight. And look at that, Alicea, Teddy, still just at 10%. He's been the much busier fighter, but that's a really bad connect percentage.
Part of the reason for that is he's been throwing from a little bit too far away. That's not by accident. That's because Mr. Wheeler has been controlling range like he is right now with those longer arms, getting off his punches at a distance where Alicea cannot be effective, cannot reach him, and then getting out of range, just like that. That's why, you just saw it, that's why there's not a good connect percentage for Alicea. Wheeler is controlling the range, controlling the distance very well.
But Teddy, if you have Alicea as your fighter, don't you have to tell him Wheeler doesn't have any power, you gotta get on the inside.
How do you get there? You have to be able to negotiate that distance properly. Maybe fake Wheeler a little bit. Get Wheeler to make that movement outside prematurely. And then step to him. Walk him down like he's trying to do right there.
Wheeler so slick. Fighting on the angles. You see when Alicea on the inside turning. Not giving him much of a target.
Give Alicea credit though. Stepping up the work rate, he's closing the gap a little bit, getting closer to Wheeler, but he's not allowing Wheeler to use that height advantage, that physical advantage of having the longer arms. In other words, Alicea fighting the fight right now that he wants to fight. Being in close, in tight, not at a range where he's leaving himself hanging.
Alicea with 19 KOs, his 24 victories. Wheeler just does not seem a candidate to get knocked out though by Alicea. He's just not giving him anything to hit like right there.
Wheeler's doing a good chance of moving, good job of moving his head, but not making Alicea pay. And as I say it, he must have heard me.
Crab Portobello.
Enjoy mouth-watering crab in new ways at Red Lobster's Festival of Crab. Entrees start at just $9.99. Red Lobster, go overboard.
Big stuff is going on here at 7-Eleven. It's the new Big Sub Combo.
Choose an Italian Big Sub sandwich.
Three kinds of meat and provolone cheese.
Or smoked turkey with Swiss.
Plus a big goal and a big grab of chips. It's a bigger, better summer.
They've spent a year apart.
Things are changing. Everything is.
But this summer, the gang from American Pie...
Check it out.
Oh, my God.
Lesbians.
...is getting back together.
You have not forgotten about me, have you?
...in the most anticipated reunion of the year.
Where's my big guy?
Oh, no.
Hey!
Dad?
American Pie 2.
I just want you to know I'm not embarrassed.
Your mother and I have been known to get frisky.
Not so much anymore.
Rated R. Now playing everywhere.
I've been talking about the importance of range, distance. Well, here it is. You can see Wheeler on the outside controlling that range, controlling that distance, using those long arms, getting his punches off in the right spots.
Between rounds, Sean Razor, the trainer of Daniel Alicea, telling him throw a right to the body and then a right uppercut. But that's a combination. You have to get on the inside to land. Alicea picking up the pace a bit. Neck percentage up to 12%. But Wheeler, and this is an interesting case for the judges, Teddy, at 25%. But he's throwing fewer punches. Some judges will look at who's the busier man, others will look at who's throwing the more effective punches, who's landing more punches. That almost comes down to the style of the judges. We're in a very strong commission state here in Connecticut. They have outstanding judges, but that's something that's often up to individual interpretation.
It shouldn't be. That's the problem with getting bad decisions sometimes, when they're not corrupt decisions, when they're just maybe incompetent. Or subjective decisions. There's a little bit too much of gray area in how to the cypher around. It's supposed to be clear. This is professional boxing, Sean. The harder, cleaner, more effective punches are supposed to carry a lot of weight.
No question, Teddy, but you agree with me that some judges reward the guy who's letting his hands go, no matter if they're landing or not.
No doubt about it. Look at the way Sugar Ray Leonard stole a lot of rounds against Marvin Hagler when Leonard made that great comeback. Hagler would do a lot of work for three quarters of the rounds, and Leonard would shoot, shine, polish. Even though some of them landed on the arm, he'd steal a lot of rounds.
Good infighting by Alicea. Wheeler stepping out of it.
This is a nice, solid fight. Nice, solid matchup. Two good styles, two good offensive fighters here. With a little bit of contrasting styles, just enough to make it a nice, interesting fight. You got Alicea, who likes to be close, who has a little pop in his gloves. And you got Wheeler, who can fight on the outside or the inside with no pop, but knows how to put punches together.
Wheeler also knows how to slip punches. Again, you see it right there on cue. Wheeler's just not getting hit on the inside.
Again, Wheeler separates himself a little bit more when he's outside. Just look here. Alicea does his best work when he gets close. Wheeler with those longer arms, I believe, should be on the outside as much as possible.
Closing seconds, round number five. We're scheduled for 10. Julian Wheeler versus Daniel Alicea. More from Foxwoods when we come back.
Sick. That'll kick you right up in the air.
Presented by 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls begins August 18th on ABC.
And she continues to dominate the net.
Here's the setup.
Spike down the center.
Check it out.
What's this?
She's like 1-800-CALL-ATT right down the center.
Hey. Oh, come here.
I'm out. Time out. Actual product demo. Right here. 1-800-CALL-ATT.
Yeah. That was fun. That was easy. Let's do it again. Come on. Let's do it again.
Save big bucks on every call. Dial 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
Well, you gotta love those shorts.
They match the hair.
Billy, get a call.
Welcome back to Friday Night Fights, presented by Miller High Life. Round number six, scheduled for 10. Julian Wheeler, the 1992 U.S. Olympian, versus Daniel Alicea, the 1990 Junior World Champion. Teddy, 106 pounds. He's gained a lot of weight in 11 years. Can't imagine being 106 pounds at 17 years old and up to 136 and a quarter for this fight at 28. You know he walks around heavier than that. Let's take a look at the power punches through five rounds. Wheeler at 43%. And again, this may be left up to interpretation for the judges because clearly Wheeler is landing at a higher percentage, but Alicea continues to be the busier fighter. He's just not getting them through.
He was speaking about weight. Wheeler has been a bigger man in his career. Last nine fights, he's been 135 pounds or heavier, seven times. He was 141 pounds twice in his last nine fights. And on the other side, Alicea has been a smaller man, turned pro, as you said, as a bantamweight. For most of his career, as a featherweight and a junior lightweight. It's only been over 129 pounds six times, 29 fights.
Wheeler, 137 pounds entering this fight. 9 years ago in the 92 Olympics, 125 pounds. That really is not much of a weight gain in that time.
Some guys put their bodies through torture when they're amateurs, and that's something that has to be looked at if there's ever a national commission as far as safety goes. There's a lot of times you'll see these amateurs keep their weight when they're young, and it really stunts their growth. They wind up not developing physically into the size that nature might have had planned for them because they torture themselves and sacrifice nutrition so much when they're young that their body just stays at a lighter weight.
The great referee Mills Lane told me that he thought it had to do with drying out when you have ring tragedies, because you very rarely see ring deaths at heavyweight. It's the much lighter weights. And Mills Lane told me he attributes that to making unnatural weights, drying out, and then your body not being able to recover from all the punches you sustain.
That's why fighters, managers, trainers, boxing in general has to be educated in those departments. And one way to educate them is there's a book out by the Nevada medical staff.
Put them out.
Good staff. Dr. Flip Pomansky, Dr. Margaret Goodman have put out a pamphlet, a book on ring safety and ring measurements for safety. That should be looked at by people.
Time.
Leather seats, automatic transmission. Nowadays, you'll hear people call this a truck. Well, a man knows a station wagon when he sees one. This car will only see off-road action if the driver backs over a flower bed. If this vehicular masquerade represents the high life to which men are called, we should trade our trousers for skirts right now.
Tomorrow, 11 people must survive a race to find a fortune.
First one there keeps it all. Go!
He said race!
$2 million. 2,000 miles.
Come on, baby!
Too many obstacles.
Who was there?
I was.
Is that the correct time?
Rat race.
Who's next?
They were.
Rated PG-13. Sneak preview tomorrow. Check local listings.
This is why I believe Wheeler has an edge so far. Combination, punching, and at the right distance. Gets those punches off, and then follows Alicea backwards with a left hook when he sees Alicea pulling out.
Julian Wheeler, the black and white. Daniel Alicea in the gray with the Puerto Rican flag. Punches through six rounds thus far. Alicea still 11%. He's been right around that 10% mark since round number one. Teddy, your scorecard, 58-56. Four rounds to two for Julian Wheeler.
As I said from the beginning, physicality. Wheeler, the longer arms, a little taller, has the edge on the outside. Alicea does his best work inside. One thing missing with that work, and you talked about it, Sean, from Alicea when he gets inside. Not enough body work, especially when he's in there with a guy who's pretty slick. And Wheeler moves that head well. You need to bang that body. Slow that head movement down a little bit. When there's distance, Mr. Wheeler is in charge.
Alicea just cannot find Wheeler on counter punches.
He's at the wrong distance, Sean. That's why he can't find him, because Wheeler's using those legs just enough to be out of range. And those long arms, he's punching at the right distance.
Wheeler not looking dangerous, like he's going to take Alicea out of this fight. We've told you since round one, Julian Wheeler is not a knockout fighter, but he really looks smooth in the ring, and he's just not getting hit a lot. We talk about Alicea's low connect percentage, but you have to give a lot of credit to Julian Wheeler. It's not just that Alicea is having a bad night. Wheeler's not a stationary target.
This is a nice, solid fight, and Wheeler's a nice, solid fighter. Both these guys were good amateurs. You talked about Wheeler, former Olympian in the 1992 U.S. team. Alicea, good amateur. 1990 junior world champion in the amateurs.
Wheeler starting to open up. No real effect on Alicea. Wheeler told us he wanted to outbox his man. He wanted to throw a lot of punches. I think he's doing that. Off balance. Body shot, he was off balance.
There's a smart move by Wheeler. Gets inside where he doesn't really want to be. What'd he do? Ties up. Alicea then gets outside.
Time. CNN Extra, Monday. They're just children, sick and in the hospital. Scared, worried, confused. What can you do to help? Some breakthrough new ideas to help kids like these. CNN Extra, Monday on CNN News. Tonight, 10 Eastern on CNN News. Heatstroke isn't the only danger from the heat wave. The long-term effects of exposure to the sun. What you do now could affect your future. Tonight, 10 Eastern on CNN News. Tune in, find out.
TBS Superstation.
There's nothing fake about this.
And it's time to separate the men from the boys.
Don't try this at home.
Hosted by Dean Cain, Ripley's is the most watched.
Oh, it never gets boring.
Number one.
It's definitely sexy.
Original series.
It's really fun.
It's quite possibly the most shocking show on television.
It does a real number on you.
Ripley's Believe It or Not. Wednesday at 8 Eastern, 8 Pacific on TBS Superstation.
Friday Night Fights presented by Miller High Life. Julian Wheeler versus Daniel Alicea, lightweights. Alicea in the gray and black with the Puerto Rican flag. Wheeler, black with white trim, having the better of it thus far. Punches in round number 7. Alicea, who had been at 11% for the fight, landing just 8 of 100 in round number 7. So throwing 100 punches to Wheeler's 52, landing a very small percentage.
So far this fight comes down to each man trying to instill their style into the fight. So far, Wheeler has been a better man in that category. He's been on the outside using his reach. A little bit more, and Alicea has been able to fight his fight, which is be a little bit closer. Again, Alicea gets where he wants to be, in close, but not going to the body enough. Goes to that head, leaves himself open when he misses.
Wheeler, with his back to the ropes, almost turns it into an offensive position, Teddy.
Well, he does. Because when Alicea gets close, what should be an advantage when he opens up offensively becomes a disadvantage. A liability. As he throws to the head of Wheeler, he misses, leaves himself wide open for counterattacks from Wheeler.
I realize Daniel Alicea is not a world champion, but Wheeler comes into this fight 26-1. You would think with all of this ability to slip punches, he would have a better record. Is that just because he lacks the knockout and guys aren't afraid of him?
Some of it is the quality of guys that he's fought. And he's fought some guys on their home turf. He's fought good fighters, Will.
Keep him up.
And he's lost some close decisions to some good fighters in their home turf. And not having the big power in his gloves. A lot of times, he'd be involved in a lot of close decision fights. They could go either way, especially if he's the out-of-towner.
In his last fight, defeated Pito Cardona, ended a personal two-match losing streak. Cardona has knockout power at this weight. Could get Wheeler out of there. Alicea has knockout power. He's having a tough night against Julian Wheeler. Round 9 when we come back.
Time.
All right, everybody, hands in the air. There's a row.
Hey! You want to die?
August 17th, bad is good again. American Outlaws.
Sadie was a beautiful woman.
She had a mustache. I think she had more than a mustache.
Rated PG-13, starts August 17th.
To you, it's a PC. But to your kids, it's a laboratory, a museum, or a rainforest. The compact Presario 5000T with Intel Pentium 3 processor. It's a place where your child can explore a world of ideas. And it's just $839. Call 1-800-331-4120 today and get a free compact printer and $50 instant rebate. Hey, why just take your kids to school when you can take them farther than they ever dreamed?
Welcome back, Foxwoods Resort Casino. Ledger, Connecticut, Friday Night Fights, presented by Miller High Life. With Teddy Atlas, I'm Sean Wheelock, in for Bob Papa. Nine, scheduled for 10 lightweights. Julian Wheeler, the 92 U.S. Olympian, versus Daniel Alicea. Wheeler has just been a tough man to hit. Look at punches through eight rounds. Backing that up, Alicea has found Wheeler just 11% of the time. Look at that tremendous advantage, though, with punches thrown. And I just have to come back to the point, Teddy, that a lot of judges would really be seduced by that type of work.
Again, those judges have to be educated and disciplined to watch, to see those punches are landing and where they are landing. That's what counts in our business. You mentioned Wheeler's six losses. Of course, he has fought two former world champions. One of those losses was to an undefeated fighter. Another loss was to Juan Lascano, top contender. Wheeler's been in there with good fighters.
Teddy, as we showed you a moment ago, Wheeler certainly used to this type of territory. The 12th time now that he has fought past the eighth round. Just the sixth time for Alicea. Alicea, who seems to either knock his men out or get knocked out, his bouts have averaged just under five rounds. Clearly not that type of fight. Teddy, see your scorecard through nine rounds. So you gave Alicea round number eight, 77-75, which means if Alicea wins rounds 9 and 10, you have this dead even.
Step back.
Alicea has stepped up his workload. Taking advantage in some spots, I believe, the last round when Wheeler was concentrating on defense.
Teddy, again, we're in a very good commission state here in Connecticut, but this is the type of fight where one judge could have it separated by a couple of points, another could have it practically a shutout. It's just, what are the judges looking for? What is their individual preference? And unfortunately, that does play on judges' minds. Do they like effective aggression? Do they like power shots? Do they like the busier man? Do they like who's forcing the tempo?
To the mistake I think Will is making right now, he's allowing Alicea to get too close. Wheeler needs to go back to what he was doing in the early rounds, punching at the right distance, not making a defensive move and allowing Alicea to close the gap.
Love your hair. Nice shirt, Al.
Thanks, it's
retro, huh?
When you eat a Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme, you just feel good.
Great tie.
Thanks, my mom gave it to me.
With its whole breast fillet, mozzarella, and Parmesan sauce.
How you feeling? Me? I'm feeling great.
It picks up the whole day.
Hey, who wants to go to the zoo?
I do.
Try Wendy's Mozzarella Chicken Supreme and have a nice day.
The penguins are in town.
Remember, Wendy's pickup window is open late, so you can eat great, even late.
Do you want to see the greatest baseball comeback in 76 years? The Indians' miracle victory over the Mariners. It's an instant classic, and the only place to see it is on ESPN Classic. Down 12-0, the Indians slug their way back into the game and into baseball history.
And Cleveland has won it!
An instant classic, Mariners, Indians, the miracle comeback. 9 p.m. Eastern, Monday, only on ESPN Classic, presented by GM. To see this history-making game, call 1-800-CLASSIC today.
Glad you're with us, everybody, for Friday Night Fights. 10th and final round, Julian Wheeler facing Daniel Alicea. Alicea has been the much, much busier man. Wheeler has just not been hit that often. Good fight, good action. Referee Michael Ortega doing a very nice job. One of the few times right there he's had to break the fighters. They fought their way out of clinches and holds. Pretty much non-stop action throughout this fight. Alicea, you see there, just landing six out of 95 punches in round number nine. That, in a nutshell, Teddy, is the story of this fight.
The story of this fight, to me, is range, distance. Right now, Alicea is where he wants to be. But he's when he's where he wants to be on the inside, Alicea, at least in my humble opinion, he doesn't concentrate on the body quite enough. And if he had earlier, maybe now Wheeler wouldn't be as fresh as he is. That's the benefit of body punching. You have to do it early.
Wheeler looking extremely fresh. Look at him still slipping those punches. Just not an easy target.
Listen up.
But again, in this case, you're talking about what can be discrepancies in the way judges look at the fight. But when one guy is making the guy miss, which Wheeler's doing a pretty good job, but in spots he's not throwing, and the other guy's throwing, even if he's not landing, hey, that guy throwing is going to have an edge, and a deserving edge. Right there, Wheeler making his punches count, trying to be a sharpshooter, picking his spots. Wheeler changing up a little bit, getting those punches off, and then getting out, changing range again.
Closing 45 seconds of this fight.
Again, it's all about distance when it comes to Wheeler. When he's punching at a distance where Alicea is at a disadvantage, Wheeler's controlling the round.
Left hand got through that time by Alicea, one of the few punches he's landed on the inside. Missing that time.
To me, the thing to watch for, watch on the outside. When Wheeler gets his punches off, he doesn't allow Alicea to close the gap. But when Wheeler goes into a defensive move, like that, he allows Alicea to close the gap. So in other words, I believe that Wheeler should get off first on the outside, then make the move. If he makes the move first, he allows the man to close the gap.
Teddy, no surprise that this fight went the distance. That seems to be the specialty of Julian Wheeler. When we come back to Foxwoods, we'll get the judge's decision. We'll find out who won this bout. Julian Wheeler and Daniel Alicea back after this.
It takes a special event for some guys to get rid of their gray hair. But for other guys, every day of their life is special. And they live it with Just for Men. More than a hair color, it's a hair rejuvenator. Just for Men gets rid of gray in 5 easy minutes. Its vitamin-enriched formula brings back a thicker, healthier, natural look. Every day of your life is special. Live it with Just for Men.
Now coming around the home turn and into the stretch. There's a horse race on the TV you really ought to see. It's full of top-notch athletes and speeding rivalries. You'll hoot and scream and holler, along you just might blow. When your pony's got him by a nose, you'll scream,
"Go, baby, go!"
The road to the World Thoroughbred Championships continues Saturday on ESPN.
Only new Cascade Scent Expressions are heat-activated to release a fresh aroma into the air while doing the dishes. It can make your kitchen quite inviting. Scent Expressions, new from Cascade.
Bow your head!
Join the adventure that rules the planet.
Here they come.
And see the movie that Richard Roper says isn't just as good as the original.
Play dead.
It's better. Planet of the Apes, rated PG-13, now playing.
Next week on Friday Night Fights, we come to you live from Chicago with a 12-round main event for the vacant USBA Welterweight Championship. Son of the former World Heavyweight Champion Leon Spinks, Corey Spinks, a record of 27-1 and 0-11 KOs. Actually refereed him one time, facing Larry Marks, 22-4 with 13 KOs. Should be an action-packed bout next week, beginning at 9 o'clock Eastern, 6 o'clock Pacific. Friday Night Fights, presented by Miller High Life. 10 rounds complete. Let's take a look at the total punches in this fight between Julian Wheeler and Daniel Alicea. Alicea landing just 113 of 1,100 punches for 10%. But Wheeler badly outthrown. Teddy, we take a look at your scorecard. You had it as a very close decision, giving it 96-94 for Julian Wheeler. Let's see how the judges score. And we go up to ring announcer Mark Bureau.
And
Here is the decision of the three judges at ringside. Judge Robert Paolino scores the bout 97-93, Wheeler. Judge Steve Epstein sees it 96-94, Alicea. And Judge Frankie Lombardi scores it 95-95. We have a draw match. A draw match.
A draw. And Teddy, that's what I was harping on. One judge is looking for Alicea as the busier fighter. Another looking to Wheeler is the man who's landing more shots. The third judge can't make up his mind. So after 10 rounds, Julian Wheeler and Daniel Alicea fight to a draw. Wheeler, off of that impressive victory over Pedro Cardona, has to be disappointed with this result. He sees his record go to 26-2, still 8 KOs. Still more to come, but we send it back now to Brian Kenny.
All right, Sean, thank you very much. Time for the classic KO. Happy birthday goes out to Carlos Palomino, who is 52 years of age today. We go back in time, Palomino's time, to win the welterweight championship of the world. Palomino versus John Stracy, June 22nd, 1976. Palomino, also a great baseball player, went on to win the welterweight title. Here he is in the classic KO.
Blistering left hook to the body, and Stracy collapses, writhing in pain. The referee moves in to pick up the count. The champion is up with a count of 8, and the fight continues. Palomino launches another attack, and once again a left hook drops the champion. Courageously, Stracy rises at a count of 8, and the referee signals Palomino to move in. The champion is hurt, and wisely, the referee steps in and stops the fight. Carlos Palomino becomes the new welterweight champion of the world.
Classic KO is brought to you by Miller High Life.
1976 looked like 1941, the footage we had. Also, I said he was a great, but Palomino was a very good baseball player and then started knocking guys out.
Beat the guy who beat Jose Napoli's for the title, lost to the guy.